Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, family.
Welcome to St. Joseph's for Mass today. Today, for announcements, I don't really have much, but there is the old announcements as normal. The parish festival is coming up. Please remember that it's only the takeout to-go meals for the parish festival. And secondly, another old announcement is about the parish, about the roof for the church. If you are interested in any way of helping out, being on the committee and making some decisions on this, we do have a couple people already interested in helping out, so thank you so much for your interest in that. But if you are interested in helping out and helping put a new roof onto our church sometime next year, please do approach me and ask and let me know that you'd be interested in helping out. And also our cemetery director, if you are interested in helping out for the cemetery at all, please do see me as well for that. Any help at all would be greatly appreciated. School began this week. I know at Sacred Hearts it was so wonderful seeing all the children back. It really brings joy in my heart to see the kids back in school. I know they were anxious to get back as well. So please do continue to pray for all the kids and all the teachers that they have a very safe and successful school year. As we begin Mass, let us stand and greet our neighbor. Today for Mass, we gather into Christ's name, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and my sisters, as we gather together today to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us say the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to the people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory.
What's going on?
Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us Put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned to Peter and said, Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. But whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Way back in 2019, it seems like a long time, I guess, for myself. A lot has happened since then. There was a survey that came out that some university put out there. And it was surveying Americans about what are you most fearful about? And not just a normal kind of fear, the paralysis, the kind of paralyzing fear that causes us to really just really get extra fearful. And some of the responses were this is all pre-COVID, I guess. So responses were corruption, pollution, people we love becoming ill or dying, cyber terrorism, extinction, climate change, not having enough money for what we need. For myself, though, probably the biggest cause of paralysis of fear is probably not having a pumpkin flavored things. though it is looking up, it is pumpkin season is starting. I was in the grocery store this past week and they had pumpkin flavored donuts, so I am good to go. I only bought 2 dozen, so I'll be good for another week or two. But Pope Francis also recently spoke about fear. And it's not the types of fear that the survey did, but a different type, even more powerful fear. That fear is the sofa.
Who's that?
Pope Francis said, in life there's another, even more dangerous kind of paralysis. It's not easy to put our finger on it. He said he liked to describe it as the paralysis that comes from confusing happiness with the sofa. In other words, to think that in order to be happy, all we need is a good sofa. A sofa that makes us feel comfortable, calm, and safe. A sofa that keeps us safe from any kind of pain and fear. A sofa that allows us to stay home without needing to work at all or worrying about anything. Sofa happiness. That's probably the most harmful form of paralysis. Following Jesus, it demands a good dose of courage, a readiness to trade the sofa in for a pair of walking shoes. And to set out new and uncharted paths, to blaze trails that open up new horizons capable of spreading joy, to take the path of the craziness of God, who teaches us to encounter him in the hungry, the thirsty, the naked, to encounter him in the sick, the friend in trouble, the prisoner, our neighbors who feel abandoned. For Pope Francis, the paralysis of the couch potato is for him the most terrifying. Over time, the sofa, it symbolizes receiving rather than giving, resting rather than serving, isolating rather than loving. And that's the battle in today's gospel reading. Jesus is leading the way of the cross, the way of self-sacrifice, the way of laying down his life, not laying down the sofa, but in the field of service. And then Peter reacts to him today and says, God forbid, Lord, no such thing should ever happen to you. To which Jesus replies, in his famous words, "Get behind me, Satan." Or in modern terms, put down their votes and get off the sofa. We've got some sacrificial loving to do. Jesus says, "Do not serve yourself, but serve me and my people." And enter into true life. The question posed by Christ in today's gospel is the same as been posed countless centuries and countless people before. Not what do I want to do, but what would Christ have me do? And who would Christ have me serve? Illness is scary. Pollution is scary. Spiders are scary. Not having a pumpkin is scary. But as it turns out, nothing is as scary as the sofa. Unlike living on the sidelines, while there is still loving and still life, and laying down our lives for others to do, our next trip to the couch is our patient's eyes. Is there more living to be done? The cross of Christ teaches us this is the way to a true, well-lived life. Lord, move our hearts off the sofa and to the cross. Deny ourselves at every moment so that we can give our lives to others. Along the road that Jesus gives to us, that's not scary. That's true living. Inspired by the guidance of Christ, let us now bring our needs to the God of all mercies.
For Pope Francis, bishop, priest, and all who teach the faith, that by word and example they may lead others to a deeper relationship with Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For national leaders, may they turn to God for guidance to enact laws and policies which serve the good of all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that the Holy Spirit inspire us to live by what is truly important in our lives, and that we be not blinded by riches, fame, or pride. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our schools, that they may be havens of learning and safety for our children, particularly at this time when so many are fearful of the spread of COVID-19 virus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are sick with the COVID-19 virus, that through the support of their doctors and nurses, family and friends, they be brought safely through this difficult period. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, for Kyle and Dan Miller, and for Arnold and Doris Bainey, may they come to enjoy perfect happiness and peace in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers and needs that each of us hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Give us, Lord, your saving help as we make these prayers with hope and confidence. Grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of operation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruits of the earth and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Bless me, God, forever.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in his paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of this death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Just another reminder for communion today. We split the church into four sections, so sections 1, 2, 3, and 4. And Deacon John will be at section 1, and I'll be at section 3. And we do these two sections first, we rotate this way. And then once both of these two sections are done, then we rotate to sections 2 and 4, and we rotate this way. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Whose feet are anointed? Is it your foot?
Thank you.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you and our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Wish you a very blessed and great week. Looks to be good weather ahead. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Is the Father asleep?